Dear students, now we will revise our square and square root chapter. In my previous class, we have discussed about the repeated subtraction method and the prime factorization method. Now we will discuss finding the square root of any number by long division method. Okay, because repeated subtraction method and in prime factorization method, it is too lengthy to find out the square root of larger numbers. But the long division method is very easy method, and in this method you can find out the square root of the larger numbers also. Here I have taken the example 1521. I will find the square root of 1521 by long division method. You follow me. If you have doubts, then you can also ask me. Okay, so in step one, what will you do? Mark off digits in pairs starting with ones digit. Here you see ones digit is one. From your right side, you will start marking pairs. Okay, so 21 is one pair and 15 is another pair. Okay, so then you will go to step number two. Think of the largest number whose square is either equal to or just less than the first period starting from the left. Okay, your first period from the left is 15. Okay, so I will take 3 because 3 is a 9. Then 4 is a 16. 16 is a greater number. 16 is more than 15. That's why I will take 3 and I will write the quotient also 3, divisor 3, then 3 is a 9. I will write here 9 below 15. Then you go to step number 3. Then we will find the remainder, and 15 minus 9 is equal to, the remainder is equal to 6. Okay, then you will go to step 4. In step 4, what will you do? Bring down the next pair of digits to the right of the remainder, and this becomes the new dividend. Okay, so next pair of digits equal 21. You will drop down the pair, not the single number. You will not drop down the single number. You will drop the pair. Your next pair is 21. You will write in the right of 6. Now it became 621, and it is the new dividend. Understand? Then step number 5. Step number 5 is double the current quotient. Your quotient is 3. Now you will double the current quotient. 3 multiplied by 2 is equal to 6. You will write 6 here. And to the right of 6, that means after 6, you will write a new number. Which number you will write, you think? And which number you will write, you will multiply by that number. Understand? Here I have written 9. After 6, I have written 9, and it became 69. 69 multiplied by 9 because I have written 9. That's why I will multiply it by 9. So 69 multiplied by 9 is equal to 621. Now you see 621 minus 621 is equal to 0. So we got the remainder 0. That's why root over of 1521 is equal to 39. Yes, one thing, after writing 9 here, you will write after 3. Okay, and the quotient will be 39. So root over of 1521 is equal to 39. I think you understood this. If you didn't understand, then you will ask me in my next class also. Thank you.